look what I see.
This is what I was talking to you guys about.
Move slowly.
So it takes about 30 minutes for me to drain the tank by about 80% and scrub the entire walls. Now, if you haven't guessed it, today is the day we begin the rescape of the 2,000 gallon aquarium. Now, today I'm only prepping the aquarium to eventually rescape it, most likely late next week or maybe late this week. I'm not sure. There's so many tanks we need to set up right now, and there's a lot of fish coming in at the end of the week. So I need to get this prepared because I don't want to have to try to do it all in one day, because if you remember, I'm rescaping this tank to the point that it has to be completely drained, completely emptied, and even the fish moved. And I want them in a smaller tank for a very short period of time, so I figured the more I get done now and in advance, the better for them. As you can see though, I've already cleaned the walls of the aquarium as well. It's not done perfectly, but it's about as good as I could do with a scrub brush. If you guys remember, I do that with this. A basic shower scrubber on an extendable arm. Perfect for those deep aquariums, long tanks, places you can't get into that are far away. And it has a detachable sponge, so if I ever want to replace that for something new, I certainly can, or I could take it off and do it by hand as well. With a quick cleaning of the tank done and the water drained, my next move is this. I need to remove all of the plants from the wood. I want to save them because some of them will come back. Others I'm going to use in some of the tanks in the racking system. I also need to remove all of the wood because this isn't going to fit in to the new scape. You'll see why in a couple of weeks. I also want to remove all of the rocks. The rocks I'm actually going to use in another scape. I love that they're already got a nice coating of algae. They look natural. They're going to look fantastic in the new scape that I want to do in one of the 120s. I'm going to leave one piece of wood in the tank though for the next few days for the biter because it does like a nice place to hide. The rest of the fish don't care. Now, if I haven't told you the story before, the freshwater stingrays have these barbs within the bases of their tails and they shed them every 3 months. Now we got 4 freshwater stingrays in there. They've been in there for several months, meaning there's probably at least 8 of these barbs floating around in this tank, most likely submerged in the substrate somewhere. I'm not gonna be able to find them today. But once all the fish are out, I'll dig around. But that's just one more thing I have to worry about is stepping on one of these. Now you can see my bucket in the background there. When I remove the plants, I'm going to toss them all in the bucket. If any are still tied down or difficult to get off, I'm going to be able to cut the line with this tiny razor blade. Anyways, I guess it's time to jump in. Wish me luck. Now once again, I'm going to be wearing some sandals in the tank just in case I do step on something. They should offer me a little bit of protection. Some people have recommended rubber boots and whatnot, wearing them in here. I'm not too worried about that. I'd rather feel the rays on my feet so I'm able to react and a little more gently with them as opposed to not being able to feel them on my feet and maybe I step on them by accident. I think this is the better option. I've also taken a shower already to rinse off any contaminants that might be on my body. Luckily, this is only going to be up to halfway up my thigh here, or up my shin, so shouldn't be that much of a problem. Hopefully I'm able to remove all of these without an issue. Again, I'm just gonna move nice and slow, respect the animals. This is their home, this is their house. Okay, so some of these are still tied. Some of these are also rooted in, so I think what I'm gonna try to do is remove them by the roots first. These plants did so well in this tank. Like surprisingly well. I'm really excited about this. And let's see if I can get this off here. Yeah, look at this one. Isn't that beauty? This is Anubias nana. Petite, I believe it is. What do we call it? There's a few plants that are tied nicely to rocks. Like this one here. No way I'm taking that bad boy off that rock. Look at that. Isn't that nice? That's gonna stay on there. I'm so happy I'm not getting soaked. No, I'm not swimming this time. I'm gonna try to remove as many of the rocks as I possibly can as well right now. I know the Beischer's home is in here somewhere, so I'm definitely gonna wanna, you know, not spook them too much. The water in here is so nice and warm though. Then again, we're in here in winter time where outside it's absolutely freezing, so. Now, one of the things I've never done with this tank is kind of move any of the rocks around. All the rocks used to be piled up nicely here, now they're kind of scattered. That's the rays doing that. So, one of the things I think is gonna happen is there's probably gonna be some detritus underneath the rocks, but that's a good thing, I'll be able to move them now. All the rays and arowana, or at least all the arowana, went behind the wood, so I'll take advantage of that and try to move as quickly as I can here. The problem with rays sometimes though is they're such a curious creature that they will come over and explore me. So I'm just going to let them do it and not spook them. I'm also moving my hands slowly through the sand while I grab these rocks in case there's any barbs trapped in there. All right, let's move on to some of the Anubias and some of the Java ferns. Isn't this amazing? You know, some of them, the Java ferns, have broken off and lodged into different parts of the wood and started a whole new plant. This is fascinating. Look, like this little piece here. This little piece was just growing on itself. I didn't put it there. Beautiful. Love it. We need new leaves on here. I add nothing to the plants. I do barely any maintenance. Nothing to the water, I mean. I just do my water changes. Look at that. Low light, low demanding plants. Definitely the way to go if you want to add a splash of green to your aquarium. Definitely a rewarding plant to have. Difficult to kill as well, so win-win. This one was tied on. These little ones are so pretty. These are slow-growing plants though, so they do have a tendency to get a little algae on the leaves. A little rinse under the water, rub it off with your thumb or your finger. They're back to looking beautifully green. I don't know if I'll be able to save every one of these plants, but I'm going to do my best. A beautiful leaf on that one. Oh, wow. Look at this. This is going to roll right off. Have you ever seen a mat of moss, something like that, before? Let's rinse it off a little bit. These things are great. Almost like a filter as well, where they will, of course, filter out debris in the aquarium. I'm not gonna be too picky here, I'm just gonna take what I can. Take all the healthiest stuff on top. You know what? That's about as much as we started with as well. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful. Was that it for moss? No, there's a few other chunks on the ends here. Yeah, this is just peeling right off. I think it's so dense, and there's so much of it, that underneath of it is dying. So that's why it's so easy to kind of peel off of it. But you know, if I did this and left it alone instead of, you know, shutting down this wood, I bet you it would all just grow right back. I want to save as much as I can. I don't know what I'm going to do with this wood, but I'm definitely not giving it away or throwing it out or cutting it up. I think I'll just store it. Maybe I'll use it in a pond in the future, make something a little natural. Who knows? This stuff was difficult to get. Definitely not letting it out of my sight. Still so much moss. I just want to take the healthy stuff. I guess it's not dying underneath, but it's certainly not as vibrant as the rest. Oh, there's still lots more in the back. If you guys remember, I was already in here taking out a bunch of plants for another aquarium. And for a couple of aquariums, actually, I've been picking out of this for a long while. So I think what I will do, you know what? We are going to add a lot of the plants back into this tank. I just like them too much, and they did so well. They deserve to come back in here. Plus, of course, they make everything look a little bit more natural, so I'll make it work. Beautiful. This is a Java fern trident. Trident narrow leaf. Ooh. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this. I want to move slowly. I am kind of excited. This one's starting to flower. Look at it right up here. That's Anubias Nana. Isn't that pretty? Now, I used a cotton thread to tie a lot of these plants in place. Some of them just got stuck into crevices, like this, for example, but others were tied to the branch with a cotton thread. And what's gonna happen over time is that cotton thread slowly starts to dissolve, leaving just the plant behind. Anything organic in your aquarium is going to rot, including cotton. Cotton is organic. It's not necessarily man-made. Boy, we got a lot of plants. So I'm finding I don't need to cut it off. I could just rip it off because the cotton is already very weak. Now, I remember I tied these together. Here it is. I made sure these wouldn't fall apart, so I used these plastic zip ties to tie it all together. I'm gonna have to move all these rocks so I can get this wood out. All right, so I'm gonna figure out what's the safest way to pull these two apart. I don't remember how I did it. I do know that this piece of wood is staying in. I'm just gonna put this aside, right over there. Maybe we can stand it up later. Alright, Joey, focus. Don't play with the wood. Alright. Oh boy. It's way heavier now that it's waterlogged. Is it tied anywhere else? Oh man. Easy. Where's the bicher? Look, all the arowana are back there.
Where's all the stingrays?
Oh boy, I don't know about this one. I must weigh over 100 pounds now. I gotta find that bicher. They're the type of fish that will lodge themselves in wood just to hide. Stay right there. I really need to find that bicher. I don't want to take out any more until I find them. Now, it's probably under here. With any luck, he'll just scoot right out of there. I hope he's under there. Uh-oh. Anybody see the bicher? Still, oh, I see you. He's there. Okay. Now that I don't want to give him a chance to scoot up under this wood anymore. I'm gonna pick this up. Oh boy. I don't see the bicher. Alright. Oh, there he is. Right over there. Okay. We're good to go. Now to get this sucker out of here. This one's even heavier. Sorry, Mike. Look what I see. This is what I was talking to you guys about. Move slowly. It better be. Oh, you're kidding me. Look at this. Look what I found. I thought it was a barb. It's a piece of wood shaped exactly like one. Isn't that something? I know they can't be in here this long without shedding them, so. We got one, two, about four. One, two, three, four. Okay. Alright, we're off to a good start. Do all the plants that we took out, I'm gonna go ahead and put them in with the discus for the time being. Just for easier access. Although plants do look good with the discus. You know, one of the fascinating things about aquatic plants is, like, depending on where you plant it in the water column, you know, pretty much closer to the light or further away, they'll grow differently. Not just they'll grow more, but for example, mosses will display differently. Anubias will grow differently. These are identical plants. This one has much larger leaves, much less. This one has many more, much smaller. This one was closer to the water surface than this one by about 2 feet. You might not be able to notice the difference on camera, but I've seen this in many different types of plants. Absolutely fascinating to see happen. It's almost as if they could, you know, be classified as different plants. Anyways, check out our haul. So some of these tanks are gonna be pretty happy. These are all low light, low demanding plants. I do nothing but water changes, guys. Wanna add plants to your aquariums? Get some Anubias. Get some Java ferns, get some Java mosses. Absolutely simple plants to keep. I'm just gonna put these guys in there temporarily, keep them wet and alive. Now we can fill it back up. Now as it fills back up, sorry, we're just gonna have to deal with the noise. I've already turned the filtration back on. I should quickly actually point out that my filtration is pump fed, not gravity fed. You see, whereas on the racking system and most sump filtration systems is that there's an overflow at the top of the aquarium, meaning that water has to flow all the way up to the top in order for that to overflow out of the aquarium into the filtration system below the tank, and then pumps return it back to the top, but the water level has to be all the way to the top for that to work. In my system, I designed it so that I can have the pumps running and filtration running regardless of the height of the water. So I never have to worry about evaporation or topping off or anything like that. Or if I want to change the height of the tank or the height of the water, maybe I want to go a little shorter for the scape or a little higher for the scape, I certainly can. But I just wanted it to remain flexible because of that. Fish are doing okay. Oddly enough, this was the, there's the bicher down in the corner there. A little piece of wood left in there for them. All of the arowana are doing fine. You can kind of see the color differences between here. That's a panda supreme and a red. And then we've got the scriptus coming in right behind it. Another red over there. But this was the way the tank was originally going to be. Then I decided I would scape it. So we threw in all that wood. I kept it pretty simple. But all this time, you know, how do you scape a 2,000 gallon aquarium? Obviously you need monster sized, you know, scaping materials, but I always wanted something more natural, something that would cover the entire back of it and sides, perhaps come out a little bit and leave the front wide open. I can't wait to show you guys what I have planned, but to be completely honest, I don't know exactly how this is going to turn out just yet. There's all the rays, little pile of rays over here. As for the plants, like I said, I'm gonna add them back in, some of them back into the 2000. As you see, tons of moss, tons of Java fern and Anubias. Some of that will go back in the 2000, I think. Others will get scattered around some of the other racking system. All the lights are off right now. I might even try a little bit in the African tank, who knows. But the rocks here I'm gonna be using up in the Central American aquarium that we need to scape soon as well.
But none of this is going to waste. I'm going to be reusing it.
So that's it for today, guys. I'm going to go ahead and continue to fill this up over the next probably 6 to 8 hours. That's it for today. If you're excited about seeing this tank get rescaped and the entire process happen and you're not subscribed to this channel yet, highly suggest you do so you don't miss any of them. And apparently there's this notification bell you're supposed to click too. I know a lot of my subscribers aren't getting notifications when my new videos are up, so make sure that you have the notification bell on as well.